My Lord, the Honorable Chief Justice of India, Sri Ranjan, Justice Ranjan Gogoi Ji, Honorable Chief Minister N. Chandrababu Naidu Garu, Honorable Sri Justice N. V. Ramana, Honorable Sri Justice L. Nageshwar Rao, Honorable Sri Justice R. Subhash Reddy, Judges of Supreme Court of India, Honorable Sri Justice T. B. Radhakrishnan, Chief Justice High Court of Telangana, Chief Secretary Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Anil Chandra Puneta, Sri Kollu Ravinder, Law Minister for the State of AP, Honorable Chief Justice of Uttarakhand, Sri Ramesh Ranganathan, former Judge of Supreme Court, Brother and Sister Judges of High Court of AP and Telangana, former Judges of High Court of AP and Telangana, Advocate Generals and Public Prosecutors of the two states, Honorable Ministers, Speaker, Members of Parliament, Legislative Assembly and Council, Chairmen and Members of Bar Council of two states, Law Officers of both states and both High Courts, Judicial Officers, President and Members of the Advocates Association, Senior Advocates, Advocates, Registrar General and other Registrars of both the High Courts, Civil Servants and Police Officers of both states, Staff of the High Court, Representatives of the Farmers who have donated the land, Agencies and Employees involved in the construction of the Judicial Complex, Print and Electronic Media, Ladies and Gentlemen. On behalf of the High Court of Andhra Pradesh, I deem it a privilege to welcome you all to the historic event in the Indian Judicial Annals, the inauguration of the new High Court building here in this historical place of Amaravati on the banks of River Krishna. We are happy to have the Honorable the Chief Justice of India amongst us on this occasion. I express my gratitude for the gesture of kindness. I express the Honorable Chief Justice of India has showered on us by being with us and inaugurating this High Court building complex. Amaravati, I am proud to say, has a unique place in this country's history. It was a place where civilizations flourished, cultures thrived, the Dharma reigned, and all religious practices and beliefs coexisted. It was a center for education and erudition whose fame has spread far and wide. Justice prevailed based on Samata and Samdarshana in this historical place. Now this capital of yore has been all set to regain its glory and revive the splendors of the past. Ancient literature says that Amaravati means the capital of heaven. It is believed that high form of civilization flourished in this part of Telugu kingdom with the recorded first legislation about 2,200 years ago. Coming back to the present, now it is a part of the contemporary constitutional polity that two states have emerged out of the old composite state. Ever since the bifurcation of the state, it is the dream of the people of Andhra Pradesh to have their own High Court. This new High Court will now facilitate the dispensation of justice to the people of the state operating from the state's capital. As a matter of record, I may remind you that Andhra High Court was established in the year 1954, carved out of the state of Madras. After its formation, the state had Kurnool as its capital and the High Court was established at Guntur. After the merger of Andhra Pradesh with the Indian state of Hyderabad in Deccan, the then Hyderabad High Court and Andhra High Court were amalgamated on 5/11/1956. Thus was formed the AP High Court. If I am permitted to take you down the memory lane, Dr. Kailash Nath Kadju, the then Law Minister, speaking on the inauguration of the new High Court of Andhra Pradesh in Guntur on 5th July 1954 said, and I quote, "The Andhra High Court is the culmination of an intense desire on the part of the people of Andhra to lead a community life of their own. This High Court will be widely welcome because it will, to some extent, bring justice near home to the parties," unquote. Dr. Kadju further expressed the confidence that the great traditions built by Madras High Court during the last 100 years will be fully maintained and that the ties between the Andhra and Madras High Court will continue to be strong and affectionate for years to come. Between that day and today, the judicial clock has turned a full circle. The AP High Court now stands as it began then without Telangana. True, the amalgamation has enriched the judicial landscape of both the states and made both the states richer with experience and exposure. Sri P.V. Rajbannar, speaking from the same dais, declared that day to be the most memorable day in the history of Andhra State. Sri Koka Subbarao, Justice Koka Subbarao, the then Chief Justice of Andhra High Court said, I quote, "We are all proud of the happy occasion. When the Andhra state came into existence, there was a fear of incompleteness. But now, with the constitution of the High Court, the long-standing desire and aspirations of Andhras have been fulfilled," unquote. Indeed, Today we share the same feeling of happiness which our predecessors felt on 5th July 1954. The line of legal luminaries who adorned the Supreme Court from Chief Justice Koka Subbarao onwards till date is long, including the present sitting judges, Sri Justice N.V. Ramana and Sri Justice L. Nagesha Rao. The Chief Justices and Judges of the Honorable High Court of Andhra and Andhra Pradesh have delivered judgments of lasting jurisprudential value. Justice H.R. Khanna once said that judges bask in the reflected glory of advocates' brilliance. So let me invoke the names of few doyens of the bar belonging to Esther years. True, the list is long, but randomly may I mention the names of Sri D. Narasaraju, Sri P. Ramchandra Reddy, Sri C. Padmanabh Reddy, Sri Ananta Babu, and Sri Manohar, and it goes on and on. Yet I must acknowledge that I have been humbled by this line of legal luminaries, for they have left a lasting impression on the legal horizon. The state has shouldered its responsibility to provide a building for the Andhra Pradesh High Court here in Amravati after the division of the state. It is now the collective responsibility of the judiciary, advocates, litigants, and every citizen to convert this building into an institution where every citizen gets his or her rights recognized, claim vindicated, pride restored, and justice delivered. Charles Dickens, in his book Great Expectations, through the character of Pip, says, and I quote, "There is nothing so fiercely perceived and finally felt as injustice," unquote. This feeling of injustice should be addressed by all the stakeholders of the institution. May I fervently hope that the letter and spirit of the Constitution must permeate every aspect of justice in the state. Many regards the legal profession as the highest form of humanity. As of necessity, we in the legal profession have to dwell into sociology, economics, finance, science, and what not. Noted jurist Naini Palkiwala said, "A lawyer who only knows a law is a mason, and one with the knowledge of history, science, and society is an architect." We may agree that there are few teething problems being faced before our High Court begins functioning at its full potential. Indeed, both the governments and the judiciary have been holding their best to minimize the discomforts. But as architects, we should take this project forward and make our Constitution, make our High Court a venerable institution of glory and splendor in all respects. This can be achieved only by the united effort of all the stakeholders. We shall endeavor to meet all our targets in pursuing our dream, the dispensation of justice to all citizens. As the legatee of this glorious heritage, all our endeavor is to hand it over to posterity with added luster and glory. The American President Barack Obama's slogan, "Yes, we can," should be emulated by us, and we should say, "So we shall." Though this High Court is the youngest of all the High Courts in the country in terms of years of existence, we are the torchbearers of a great legacy we have inherited from the unified Madras High Court, Andhra High Court, and the United High Court of Andhra Pradesh. May I remind all the stakeholders that we should proudly proclaim and also prove to the world that we can carry with us the tradition, culture, and conventions of three states and three high courts, which very few courts in the country could boast about. The august presence of the Honorable the Chief Justice of India adds luster to the event and inspires us to be unrelenting in realizing our dreams to make this court one of the best in the country. The Honorable the Chief Justice may guide us with his rich and varied experience of dispensing justice to about seven states under one judicial umbrella. Indeed, the High Court of Guwahati till recently dealt with issues of seven states, seven governments, with seven advocate generals functioning in one court, a rare scenario on the judicial horizon of our country. At this historic moment, I will be failing if I do not mention the sacrifices made by all the stakeholders, particularly staff members, lawyers, advocate clerks, etc., in having the High Court established here and making it fully functional too. On this august occasion, I call upon all the stakeholders of the legal fraternity to rededicate themselves for the growth of this institution. May the God Almighty give us the strength and perseverance to succeed in this task of building this institution. I congratulate one and all on their being part of this historic occasion. Jai Hind. Thank you.